Shalom. First and foremost, all praises and glory to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakah Kodash. Double honors unto the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone that do rule exceptionally well. Also, shalom, salutations, mercy, and blessings to all you sincere brothers out there that push this word with truth and with faith. My name is Thabwa Amath of Great Millstone Northwest. Back with another lesson. I'm not exactly 100% sure what I'm going to entitle it, although the topic and the point and the message that I want to put out is based around the fact that I think I'm going to title it, Are You Prepared for the Kingdom? Or Are You Prepared to Be a King? Or Are You Preparing to Be a King? Or something of the sort, right? I'll figure it out after I finish, after I actually finish the lesson. Now, the reason I'm saying this is because earlier this morning I watched the video that the elder Ariella in Dallas put up about the brothers that was eating. You know, I think it was Have Dignity in This Truth, or something of the sort, roughly paraphrasing the title. But it had my wheel spinning, so to speak, and I was thinking, like, we're down here, we're supposed to be training and preparing ourselves to take over the world, you know, with the of course with the help and the power of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, all right. But we're preparing to rule over different parts of the world, you know, underneath Yahweh Shai. And for you to be a king, you have to actually behave. You got to be getting yourself prepared now to be that king, man. All right. You can't think that, oh, no, it's just all going to come once, you know, Yahweh Shai comes. I mean, to a certain point, that is true. But you got to be showing that you can actually handle the responsibilities of it now, even while you don't have a kingdom to rule over, man. Okay, and it's all in the preparation of you know, the coming of the Lord. Now, it reminds me of Matthew's the 25th chapter, speaking about the virgins, man, the 10 virgins. All right, I don't really want to grab it. This is something that's been, you know, most brothers are aware of Matthew chapter 25, the parable of the 10 virgins. All right. Matthew 25, 1, all the way through to verse 13, all right? And Yahweh Shai spoke constantly about the kingdom of heaven and how the kingdom of heaven was like, man. And with the parable of the virgins is that you had five that was prepared, and you had five that wasn't prepared, man, all right? So when the time came, guess what? Those that was prepared, they received the reward, and those that wasn't prepared got kicked to the dust, man. You know, they got booted. So it's gonna be the same situation, man. You got guys that are supposed to be preparing for the upcoming trouble times. They're supposed to be preparing for Yahweh Shai to return in seeks of a crown and of some land, man. All right, of a title of the elect. You know, that's what we're after here. We're seeking that salvation, man. But you got people out there that don't really take this thing that serious, you know. They don't take it for face value, or maybe, you know, for whatever reason, that demon has been on you, and you realize that you need to be more serious and just take heed to that, man, and be more serious, because we have to prepare for the kingdom of heaven, man. I do want to jump over one chapter. I'm gonna jump to Matthew chapter 24. I'm gonna read these verses real quick. This is Matthew 24. Verse 42, it says, "Watch therefore, for ye know not what hour your Lord doeth come. But know this, that if the good man of the house had known in what watch the thief would come, he would have watched." All right. So maybe you got, maybe you believe in this thing, and maybe you are sincere, you know, but for whatever reason, that demon's been on you to where you haven't been taking this as a life or death situation. You haven't been taking this truth as serious, you know what I'm saying, as deadly serious as it actually is. You've been playing around, All right, well, now's the time to get serious, because just as the scripture say, if the good man of the house had known in what watch the thief would come, he would have watched. All right, so if we would know when everything's going to pop off, when the time is too late, if we know when the time is too late, then we'll prepare all the way up into that moment, man. But we don't know. Hey, the time could be too late tonight, man, you know, in an hour from now, you know, it could be too late. You don't know when the famine of the word is going to come. All right. You don't know. They could drop a law at any time saying that, you know, if you preach the word, then you're an enemy. You know, they can label anybody. They can drop a terrorist attack at any time and then blame it on the Hebrew Israelites, man. And then what are you going to do? All right. Because you've been playing around. You wasn't out there being serious about this word. You're out there playing around, man. You're out there joking and whatnot, rather than being serious, rather than studying up, you know, soaking in this wisdom, knowledge, understanding, putting these acts to work, all right? Because if they come and snatch you, if the FBI roll up in some black Suburbans, man, to every Hebrew Israelite that's out there, right? No matter where you at, say you at work, all of a sudden, like five black Suburbans or three black Suburbans come up, all blacked out, and you know what I'm saying, these dudes, men in black, jump out and grab your ass without saying nothing to nobody, you know what I'm saying, and just snatch you and take you away. What are you gonna do, man? You know, do you got the Lord fighting for you? Do you got these scriptures soaked up enough to where you know how to handle yourself in that type of situation? You know, are you gonna still stand firm for the name of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai in that situation? And that's something everybody got to be asking themselves, man. That's why you have to be mentally prepared for the kingdom of heaven, because we are going to receive kingdoms, man. Lord willing, we be men of the elect, all right? The elect is going to receive, they're going to receive people, man. They're going to be rulers over people, man, okay? And see, the beautiful thing about the elect is they know how to be a servant, and they'll know how to be a ruler as well, man. You know, they won't just think that they only are a ruler. You know, they know that they're still a servant to Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, no matter what. Okay? Because that's really what's important. All right, reading on, it says, he would have watched and would not have suffered his house to be broken up. He would not have suffered his house to be broken up. Therefore, but ye also ready in as such an hour as ye think not the Son of Man cometh. So Yahweh Shai is going to come when you ain't expecting it, man. Some people are going to get caught with their pants down, you know? You're going to get caught with your pants down, not knowing what's going on, man. Why? Because when you should have been watching, you was playing around. You was taking this thing as a joke, as a game, rather than taking it for the serious situation that it is, man. And the Most High could jack you up at any moment. Don't you know that? Don't you know that you driving home today, you know, you're listening to whatever day you're listening to this video. Don't you know that later on this day, the Most High can call you back to him? He could take your spirit. You know what I'm saying? Or he can just mangle up your body and leave your spirit in a mangled up body, man. Cause a car accident to happen, man. You know, cause a bizarre fucking fire or an earthquake or something to jack you up, you know. Hey, anything, he could cause a plane to fall out the sky and hit the building that you're in, man. You gotta be fearful of the Heavenly Father, man, because he's not playing around. This isn't a game to him, all right? And this isn't a game to us that's sincere either, man. This is serious business here, okay? Let's see, what do I want to do? Let's go to Mark chapter 13. I like these Yahweh Shai parables, man, so let's go to another one. Mark chapter 13. I'm thinking it's around here, verse 30. Let me see, where do I want to go? Actually, it's verse 32. Mark chapter 13, verse 32. But of that day and that hour knoweth no man. No, not the angels which are in heaven, neither the Son, but the Father. Take ye heed, watch and pray, for ye know not when the time is. Okay, so you don't know when the Most High is going to say, all right, now's the time for this to pop off, or now's the time for that. You don't know, man. So you got to be prepared. You got to be mentally prepared for anything that comes down your way. Mentally prepared to stand bold for Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, man. Okay. behaving yourself as such, like the elder Ariella got into, man. You know, you got to be behaving yourself properly, man. All right. And the apostles, the elders, you know, lightweight. Hey, Israel's been getting on this topic, man. You know, all the great millstones basically been getting on this topic about how you behave yourself, man. You know. Reading on, it says, for the Son of Man is as a man taking a far journey, who left his house and gave authority to his servants. Okay, so Yahweh Shai, it says he left his authority to his servants, man. And as a servant, guess what? You're there to serve, man. You're not there to be a ruler. You're a servant, okay? You got to know when you're a servant and when you're a ruler, man. And you got to know how to still be a servant while you're a ruler. Let's put it like that, okay? It says, and to every man his work, and commanded the porter to watch. Watch ye therefore, for ye know not when the master of the house cometh, at even, or at midnight, or at the cock crowing, or in the morning. So you don't know when your house shy is going to come back, man. He didn't give you no time frame. He just left and told you to keep working, you know? He didn't say, okay, I'm going to be back in an hour. I'm going to be back at 7 o'clock on the dot, you know? You know how parents will leave their kids with a babysitter and be like, okay, we'll be back at 10:30, or we'll be back by 11. You know what I mean? So the babysitter got all that time, but they know when to start expecting that parent back. They're not worried about the parent coming back at 9, but come around 10:15, okay, the parents can show up, man. All right? So they got to be more on top of their stuff. Hey, we're not in a time where it's like 9 or 9:30, man. It's always 10:15, you know, fitting the situation, fitting the example that I gave. It's always 10:15, man. They could pop up at any moment, man. Everything can go to shit at any moment, man. All right? Most high can have it where this dollar collapse and everybody goes slap stupid and start rioting in every city in America, you know? And if that happens, then what are you going to do, man? Huh? You going to join that multitude for the evil? Or are you just going to handle your business like a man and get to whatever safe zone you got, you know, and pray to the Lord, man? All right? Get around brothers and counsel about what the next step is, man. Reading on. It says, least coming, suddenly he find you sleeping, man. So, hey, if your house shot come, it says, is he going to find that faith on the earth, man? All right? Because if he comes and he finds you sleeping, hey, Paul told us that it was high time to wake out of our sleep because our salvation is nearer than we believe, right? Roughly paraphrasing the scripture. He told us that, man, you know? So, hey, guess what? You can't be caught sleeping, man. And some of you brothers out there are sleeping. Some of you guys is you dozing off, man. You yawning hard, you know? You're not asleep, but you yawning really hard, man. You fighting them eyelids, man, you know? You gotta realize, you gotta know methods on how to wake yourself back up. That's what the apostles be talking about. You gotta get that fire back, man. You gotta find that method to wake yourself back up, man. Just like if you driving, you can't be falling asleep on the road. You gotta find a method, to get you woke, man. You know, roll all them windows down, let that cold air come in, you know? Sing along with the music on the radio or something. You know, stop and get a hot beverage, some tea or some coffee or something to drink. You know, kind of get that spark back, you know. So it's the same thing. If you're sleeping, if you're getting sleepy in this thing, man, look, hey, if you're getting sleepy in this thing, you got to pray to the Heavenly Father that he don't take the spirit away from you, man. You know, you got to pray that he wakes you up as if you just took a nice long, you had a nice night's sleep. And it's morning and it's time to get up and you know, you're all energized and ready to go. You gotta pray that he keeps you in that mind state rather than have you where you dozing off, man. Okay? Reading on, it says, and what I say unto you, I say unto all, watch. So we gotta be watching out there, man. Cause we're preparing to receive a great reward. We're preparing to receive the kingdom of heaven, man. Okay, that's no light thing right there. That's nothing to be, you can't joke your way into the kingdom of heaven. You can't play around your way into the kingdom of heaven. You got to be serious, man. And I can't stress that enough. I really can't. Let's go to Luke chapter 21, verse 36. Okay. It says, watch ye therefore and pray always that ye may be accounted worthy to escape all these things that shall come to pass and to stand before the Son of Man. Hey, man, that's beautiful right there, man. That's beautiful. You gotta, you have to watch, man. You gotta be on your guard, man. Okay? Because we are prepping. We are seeing everything that's done wrong. All right? While learning everything to do right. You see what I'm saying? You gotta be on your job, man. You gotta be in your lane, like all the way 100 with it. Okay. Reference to a little boosie bar. Anyway, yeah, it says, I'm gonna stop stressing the watch part of it. Let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 16 real quick. Alright, 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 13. Okay. Alright. Last one. Watch ye, stand fast in the faith, quit you like men, be strong. Okay? Let all things be done with charity. All right, that was the point. Okay? But watch you, stand fast in the faith, quit you like men, and be strong, man. All right? That's all we need to do. And if we do that, guess what? We're going to be all right. If you don't do that, if you waver anywhere in the process of it, all right? If you waver anywhere in the process, you ain't on your watch. All right, you're not standing fast to what you've learned. You switching up stuff. All right, you're not behaving yourself like a man of the Lord. Hey, guess what? And you getting weak in this faith. Hey, if you're doing any of that, man, you need to be praying to the Heavenly Father to increase you. You know, and even if you ain't doing any of that, you need to be praying to the Heavenly Father to increase you, man. All right, because it's only by the will of Yahweh Hashem Yahshua that we're gonna make it through this thing, man. That's the only way we're going to make it into the kingdom of heaven. And I'm trying to be ushered into the kingdom of heaven rather than to be born into it, man. You see what I'm saying? I'm trying to take part of Yahweh Shai's inheritance, man. Let's jump to, actually, hold, I was going to grab something in Proverbs, but before that, let's grab this in Sirach, the 10th chapter. Snaps. Let me see. Let's start right here at 1. It's Sirach chapter 10, verse 1. A wise judge will instruct his people. Okay, now we're all judges, as the elders, the apostles, and I think Elder Ariala said it as well. We're priests. Okay, we're all judges, and we're also priests, man, seeking to be princes and kings, man. Okay, it says he'll have a nation of kings and priests. So we're seeking to be ruling over the people. Right now, we're supposed to be judging the cities that we're in, going out there on the highways and the byways. When them people come up, we're supposed to be judging them, man. You know, instructing them on which way they're supposed to go, or condemning them. Because just as Yahweh Shai said, anything that you shall bind, it shall be bind. And anything you shall loose, it shall be loosed, man. All right. So we're in that office of a judge. It says a wise judge will instruct his people, and the government of a prudent man is well ordered. All right. That's why there's order in Great Millstone, man, because that government is got to be well ordered, because this is really the body of Yahweh Hashem Yahshai. All right. It says, as the judge of the people is himself, so are his officers. And what manner of man the ruler of the city is, such are all they that dwell therein. So you can't be lackadaisical, man. All right. You can't be lackadaisical. You can't be like this is all fun and games. And this is Elder Ariala said, this is cute. Right. You can't be thinking that, because guess what? It says, as the manner of the manner of man, the ruler of the city is, so are all they that dwell therein. So you think Yahweh Shai is going to give you a kingdom when all you do is you basically bullshitted your way throughout the truth? All the years in the truth, all you was doing was just bullshitting, man. Just a warm body on the side, but not really getting your hands dirty, getting the dirt underneath your nails, digging in. All right. You think the Yahweh Shai is going to give you anything for that? No, man. All right, verse 3, an unwise king destroyeth his people, but through the prudence of them which are in authority, the city shall be inhabited. And our kingdom, it was written that the world to come the kingdom of heaven, when the kingdom of heaven is established, that it will flourish, man. All right? It's written that it will flourish. Okay? So, you can't be an unwise. He's not accepting any unwise kings, man. And if you're joking around and fooling around with this truth, then you're unwise. That's point blank period, man. If you think this is a game, then you're unwise. You're not going to receive that reward of a kingdom, man, because that's a gift. And if you can't handle the gift, then you ain't going to get it, man. As it's written, to him that is evil to himself, to whom could he be good? You know? To whom could he be good? Matter of fact, let's grab that, man. What is that? Proverbs 14? Proverbs 14:14-28. No, that's not it. What was it? Proverbs 25? Proverbs 25. Salaki. Proverbs 25:28. No, this ain't it. But this is good too though. Right here. This isn't quite what I was looking for. But this is good too. He that have no rule over his own spirit is like a city that is broken down and without walls. And guess what? If you're behaving yourself unwise, if you don't got yourself in check, if you don't got yourself in the manner of a king, then you have no rule over your spirit, which means that you're like a city that's broken down, meaning you can anything can come up against you, man. All right, we're going to have a strong kingdom in the kingdom of heaven, man. All right? It's going to be strong. It's going to be impenetrable. All right? It's going to be impenetrable. Hey man, if you playing around, hey, you ain't going to receive the reward you think you're going to get, man. Let's jump back to Sirach. Maybe it's Sirach 14. Huh. Let me see. Let's check on that. Sirach or Ecclesiasticus, chapter 14. Oh, here it is right here. Yeah. So Sirach chapter 14, verse 5. It says, he that is evil to himself, to whom will he be good? He shall not take pleasure in his goods, man. So You evil to yourself, meaning that you playing around, you ain't doing good by your spirit. It says, to whom will you be good? So why would Yahawashi give you a portion of his kingdom if all you're going to do is mistreat it, man? All you're going to do is basically what Esau is doing to the world right now. And that, man, that's not going to be tolerable in the kingdom of heaven, man. All right? That's not something that you, man, whew. I'm getting flustered over here, man. I'm getting flustered over here thinking about that, you know, because that's something that just ain't going to happen, man. You ain't going to have nobody that don't know how to behave yourself on this side in the world, you know, but yet you're going to magically just be all together in the kingdom. Nah, man, it's not going to work, man. All right. You got to show that inkling, that twinkle in your eye right now, man. Okay. You got to show that right now. Before you can go full blaze. All right. Let me see. I think the point was made. I want to grab one more scripture. Because I've been speaking about how Yahawashi is going to. He's going to give us a kingdom of heaven. All right. This is John chapter 14 verse 2. All right. It says, in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. So Yahawashi is preparing a place, man. He's preparing a place for them that actually believe in him. The ones that are actually sincere about pushing forth his message. Doing the work of gathering his sheep while he's away, man. All right? He's looking for those sincere guys. He says he's preparing a place for them, man. Okay? He's reserving a spot for them. All right? They're going to have their own spot that Yahawashi put together for them in love, man. All right. And that's powerful, man. That's a beautiful thought right there, man. That's something that warms your spirit to think about, man. All right. That's something that puts a smile on your face, thinking that you could possibly be one of the ones that Yahawashi went and handpicked a kingdom for, man. A portion of his kingdom. He was like, yeah, I'm going to give this to this guy, you know, with you in mind, you know. Because it ain't going to be no cookie cutter. Jake don't work like that. Jake don't do no cookie cutter bulk sale. You know, it ain't like Walmart where you go and everybody buys the exact same thing. the exact same brand of stuff. Nah, what Yahweh Shai is going to be presenting to you is going to be uniquely crafted for you, man. All right? Just like your spirit is uniquely crafted by the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Shai is going to uniquely craft your portion of the kingdom for you, man. All right? Your gifts, the things that was given to you is unique, man. The next brother don't got the exact same measure you got in any topic, in any subject. You know? Everybody got a completely different measure, man. But it all balances out in the spirit. And that's what's important, to be balanced out in the spirit, man. And you guys are sitting here playing around with this truth. You don't got no understanding, so you definitely ain't got no balance, man. All right? You definitely don't got no balance if you think this thing is a game, man. Anyway, reading on. It says, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. So you know the way to go, man. All right? And the way is through Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, through faith and sincere works, you know, in the name of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, man. And that's all that really matters, man. But hey, pretty much that's the point. That's the lesson. Lord willing, this was edifying, and Lord willing, the message was received. Again, all praises and glory to Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. Double honors onto the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone that rule well, you know, continually feeding the flock. And also, shalom, citations, mercy, and blessings to the sincere brothers out there pushing this word with truth and faith. Until next time, shalom.